John Knox, The History of Reformation in Scotland. Hello and welcome to the discourse. We are at the end of our discussion on the Elizabethan age of English literature. The last literary figure of the Elizabethan era of English literature that we will discuss is John Knox. He was more known for his theologian and political activities. John Knox was born in 1514 and he died in 1572. He was a Scottish minister, preacher and theologian who led the Reformation movement in Scotland and founded the Presbyterian Church of Scotland. Presbyterianism was a part of Protestant Reformation and was supported by John Calvin. Knox was an active Protestant preacher in Scotland, while Scotland was under the French influence of Roman Catholicism. Regent Mary of Guise was a Roman Catholic and she was ruling Scotland. As a result, Knox was exiled and he went to Geneva, where he came in contact with John Calvin. In Geneva, he led the English refugees and Church of England and was favoured by King Edward VI of England, who made him a royal chaplain. However, he had some disputes with Church of England over liturgy and he broke off with Church of England. He returned to Scotland and led the Protestant Reformation again. This movement soon became a rebellion and Regent Mary of Guise was disposed of her ruling power, after whom Mary the Queen of Scotland held the reins. Queen Mary of Scotland was also an adherent of Roman Papal and hence Knox had major disputes with the new Queen too. Queen Mary of Scotland had support of Roman France as she was consort of Francis II, the King of France. The French had a plan to dispose Queen Elizabeth of England and unite France, Scotland and England. John Knox continued to warn Queen Elizabeth and revolt against the French designs. After the death of Francis II, the Queen of Scots decided to marry Don Carlos of Spain, who was rumored to be involved in the murder of Francis II. John Knox not only opposed this marriage, he ensured that Queen Elizabeth too opposed it in a strong manner. Queen of Scots was then arrested and John Knox continued to demand her execution until she was executed. John Knox was a primary figure of the Protestant Reformation in Scotland and he played an important part in establishing the Elizabethan reign. His major literary works of importance were A. The First Blast of the Trumpet Against the Monstrous Regimen of Women, and it was published in 1558. B. The History of Reformation in Scotland, and it was published posthumously in 1586. The First Blast of the Trumpet Against the Monstrous Regimen of Women. It was a rhetoric pamphlet against the rule of Regent Mary of Guise. The pamphlet basically suggests that rule by females is against the teachings of Bible. John Knox was a scholar of biblical matter and he was a student of law and politics too. He not only preached sermons but used his own faculties to interpret the Bible in current day-to-day situations of his time. He was a staunch Protestant reformer and since Regent of Guise adhered to Roman Papal, there was a strong case of antagonism. With the help of French King, Regent of Guise tried her best to curb the Protestant movement in Scotland. During that time, Queen Mary I of or the Bloody Mary was also holding power in England, while Regent Mary of Guise held power in Scotland, and both were Roman Catholic, with strong reasons to curb and torture Protestants. The First Blast of the Trumpet was basically written against the rule of Queen Mary I of England. In this work, Knox opposed both the Roman Catholic queens and wrote, God, by the order of his creation, has deprived women of authority and dominion, and from history that man has seen, proved and pronounced just causes why it should be. The First Blast of the Trumpet Against the Monstrous Regimen of Women was divided in three sections. The first, that gynarchy was repugnant to nature, second, a contumely to God, and finally, the subversion of God, good order. The History of Reformation in Scotland. It is a five-volume book discussing the whole history of Protestantism in Scotland till the year 1567. During the Scottish Reformation, the Protestant nobility asked Knox to write history of Protestant Revolution in the year 1559. He wrote a pamphlet containing pertinent historical events of Protestantism in Scotland. It was a short work on which Knox continued to put efforts, and soon it became a large voluminous work with 5 books. The 5th book was published first in 1564. John Knox's The History of Reformation is being considered a reliable source of history since 1564. John Knox was a master of biblical matters, and he was a student of law and politics too. He not only drew inspirations from biblical sources in moral matters, but he also tried to implement them in practical life and in explaining the laws and system. He used his biblical knowledge and knowledge of law and reason to justify the resurgence of and establishment of the new Scottish Church against the traditional and oppressive Roman Catholic Church. The first book of Knox's history covers events from the beginnings of the Scottish Reformation up to 1559. The second book was the pamphlet that he wrote and published in 1599. The fourth book recorded the events from August 1561 to June 1564. The fifth book covers the period from September 1564 to August 1567, when Mary was forced to abdicate the throne. So this was all about John Knox, the Scottish reformer. We will now begin with the Jacobean age of English literature in the upcoming edition to this series. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.